Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Well, it's time for us to give God some praise.
Of God's word. It's another day's journey.
Hallelujah.
And I'm glad about it.
Hallelujah.
I don't know about you, but I'm happy to be inside the house of the Lord. Just one more time, amen?
Yeah.
Scripture readings coming from Psalms 24. And it reads, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. For he has founded upon the seas and established it upon the floods. Who shall ascend unto the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up the soul unto vanity nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive the blessings from the Lord and the righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob. Lift up your head, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors,
yes.
And the King of glory shall come in.
Hallelujah.
Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your head, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory, and the word of the Lord is already blessed. You may take your seats. Let us pray, Lord. We come saying thank you. We thank you for another opportunity to be in your house. And Lord, we pray, God, that you would have thine own way. God, do what you want to do in this house. And God, we pray, God, that you will throw your weight around. Don't let this service be an ordinary service, but let deliverance take place. And we give your name all the praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and thank God. Come on, let's clap our hands. Hallelujah. Amen. Sister Trudy is in the house. Come on, let's stand up. Amen. And she leads us in praise and worship. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Trudy, he's worthy to be praised. Amen. This is just another day that the Lord has made, and we should be glad about it. I woke up this morning.
Oh.
church. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Being good stewards of God's house. Amen. Amen. As has already been mentioned, today is Grace Temple 69th church anniversary. Amen. Amen. 3 o'clock. Actually, immediately following our worship service, they will be serving dinner on the ground. Amen.
Amen.
So we're not going to hold you too long here. Amen. We want you to go and get you some good food at the Grace Temple Church. Amen. Amen. Right is right. We want you to be too. It's going to be a great service. Pastor Jack Wilson, one of our sons in the ministry, will be preaching. I believe he's preached here before. Amen.
Amen.
And he's going to be preaching again at 3 o'clock. Amen. So we're going to do what we do here. We're going to go over and celebrate 69 years of ministry at Grace Temple. Amen. Sister Shuni's coming back, and the Cedar Grove Choir is coming down for a musical selection. Come on, let's thank God for our choir this morning.
Let's just give it up for our choir. Our choir from Faith in the Choir Rehearsal, they traveled such a long way. We just want to acknowledge them on this morning. Amen. Amen.
Come on, let's see how
for our corporate prayer. Amen. This is time we all come together and meet at the altar to pray together. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And it's a special moment that I actually enjoy during my worship experience, because I really believe that a family that prays together stays together. Amen.
Amen.
And so let's all come down to the altar and let's grab hands and let's go to the throne of grace. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Christ still works.
Yes. Amen.
All right. Well, I just got to get the camera. So I want to segue.
Did you get his face?
God, we pray, God, that you would touch everyone who's at this altar. God, whatever they're facing, whatever they're going through, God, we place it at your feet now in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we're praying now for your strength, God, that you would give us peace that surpasses all understanding. God, we pray, God, that you would hear our cries today. Lord, we need you now more than we've ever needed you before. God, show yourself present. Lord God, we are standing in need of a blessing, God, and we ask, God, that you do it for us in the name of Jesus. God, we pray, God, that you will forgive us for every one of our sins, God, knowingly and unknowingly, God. God, we're praying even now for our bishop, God, as he's traveling to Calvary. God, give him preaching power now in the name of Jesus. God, we ask for a different portion of your anointing, God, that will rest upon his life. Lord God, we thank you for 69 years of faithful service, God. Thank you, Jesus, that you're still with us. And God, we're praying even now for the Cedar Grove Church. God, we thank you for keeping us together. God, we thank you for keeping the doors open. God, we thank you for every member. We thank you, God, for every leader of this church. God, give us strength to endure during the test of the season. God, God, hold us up with your Holy Ghost power, God. God, I pray, God, that you touch this house, God, from wall to wall, God, from pew to pew, God, from door to door. God, let us meet you here in the name of Jesus, God. And I pray, God, that whenever we walk through these doors, God, that when we leave out, we'll leave out delivered, we'll leave out changed, we'll leave out set free. And I bind the enemy now in the name of Jesus. God, I bind the spirit of distraction. I bind the spirit of depression. I bind the spirit of giving up. God, I plead the blood of Jesus over this house, and I claim victory even now, because you are able, God. And I pray, God, that you continue to be our shepherd, and we shall not walk by anything, God. And I thank you for your word, God. You said in your word, God, that no weapon formed against us shall be able to prosper. God, you said that if we have enough faith, that we can tell the mountains to move out of our way. And God, we thank you for giving us the power. And God, as we have prayed our last prayer, we sung our last song. God, we pray, God, that you would lead us over to the other side. We may praise your name forever. And we give your name all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And then God, come on, let's clap our hands. Let's give God some praise. Come on, if you've been to believe that prayer, come on and clap your hands and give God some praise. This time we're going to prepare our hearts for our tithes and offering. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to prepare our hearts for tithes and offering. Amen. Amen. Tithing and tithes and offering is a part of worship. Amen. With the same enthusiasm and the same excitement that we receive singing and dancing and the instruments, it is the same excitement that we ought to have when we give unto God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let me talk to myself. Amen. Amen. We ought to have the same excitement when we're giving unto God. Amen. Brother Josh is coming now. We're going to stand and we all want to bring our gifts to the Lord. We do understand that the Bible teaches us to give our 10% unto him. Amen. We're going to pray first. Amen. We're going to pray first and we're going to bring our gifts to the Lord. Lord, we thank you for these seed gifts. God, we thank you for the opportunity to give unto you. And I pray, God, that you turn this off from recurring use to spiritual use. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God. For wherever you are, come on, let's bring our gifts to the Lord. Amen.
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 Somebody pray for me. Have me on their mind.
This morning, our First Lady gave me an envelope to read to the Cedar Grove family. Amen?
Amen?
And it reads as follows: to my Cedar Grove family, just a cheery little note intended to express a really happy thank you for all your thoughtfulness for my birthday. You are the best. I love you all. Sincerely, First Lady Grimes. Come on, let's clap. This is why I say we have one of the greatest first ladies in the world. She's so humble and meek. Anytime that you do anything for her, she always expresses her gratitude to anyone. Amen?
Once again,
come on, let's take a for our first lady. Everyone, it's preaching time.
Amen.
I said it's preaching time.
Amen.
Anybody in the room with me? Hallelujah. Stand with me as we sing this hymn, and we're going to get right into the word. Amen? Amen. Pass me not, oh gentle Savior. Amen. Jesus' name we pray, amen, and thank God. Matthew chapter number five, verse number six, we give honor to our bishop in his absence. We thank God for him privately and publicly for allowing me this opportunity, amen. To all of my tears of leadership, to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, Matthew chapter number five, reading verse number six. Our bishop has been dealing with the last couple weeks, Beatitudes, amen?
Amen.
So we're going to continue on that preaching series. Matthew chapter number 5, beginning at verse number 6, and it reads, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I just want to talk for a few moments this morning from the subject title, How to Be Satisfied.
Yeah.
How to be satisfied. In today's time, statistics and society says that a fat person is satisfied by eating. that a thirsty person is satisfied by drinking. Also, society says that a policeman is satisfied when a criminal is brought to justice. They also say that a doctor is satisfied when a patient is fully recovered. A judge is satisfied when justice is served. A Christian is satisfied when a soul is saved. These are things that satisfy the human body. But in the spiritual realm, God is saying that there are certain things that as believers should automatically satisfy our spirit. But the reason why that we are not being satisfied is because we allow the wrong things to enter into our spiritual body. Do I have a witness in here? There is no way that a person who is trying to lose weight can be satisfied with their weight loss if they continue to eat whatever they want to eat. Do I have a witness in here? In order to be satisfied, there are some things that we need to do as Christians. So the Bible teaches us that blessed are they which hunger after righteousness. This is a scripture that is not often preached or read in certain churches because it's dealing with holiness. It's dealing with righteous living because we always say that I fall short of the grace of God, but because of God's grace, I'm still covered. But the problem with that is we read in Ephesians chapter number 6 where it says, shall we continue in sin where grace may not abide? And the answer is no. Just because I'm covered by the grace of God, it does not give me the liberty to do whatever I want to do. Do I have a witness in here? Yes, when I turned 18, officially I was grown. But living in my grandmother's house, there are still some rules and regulations that I have to follow. Just because I pay taxes and just because according to the system I'm now an adult, it does not mean that I can come in the house 2, 3 o'clock in the morning and everything be okay. It doesn't mean that I can just have any old body in the house and grandmama don't know who's in the house. So there are some things that we need to do in order for us to be satisfied. But if you really want to be satisfied with God, then you have to live a holy life. You have to live a life that is pleasing unto God. Now watch what I said. You're trying to live a life pleasing unto God and not unto man. It's going to get quiet right here. Because we come to church and we want to be seen. We want to be noticed. We want everybody to give us accolades and to give us credit. But God is saying, I'm not looking for those who's living a perfect life just so their name can be called on Sunday mornings. But I'm looking for somebody who wants to live a holy life just because it's the right thing to do. If you call yourself a Christian, if you call yourself a man or a woman of God, baby, you gotta act like it. You gotta act like you're saved. You gotta act like you got some sense, because God wants us to have holiness. Tomorrow, I start a brand new journey in my life. I'm going back to school to finish my degree, and now that I read in the book, it says that a leader has to have integrity. check your heart. You're only saved by the status on your Facebook. Baby, there's something wrong with your heart. You gotta make sure that you have a Michael Jackson moment and look at the man in the mirror and ask yourself the question, do I represent God in the right way? So now, if you want to be satisfied with God, number one, please write this down. You have to be committed to his will. You have to be committed to his will, because God's will for your life is for you to be blessed. But you miss out on your blessings when you sin and come short of his glory. You mess up your
word, and I got a spirit on the inside. There were certain things
Mama Wilson, that I was able to do when I was single. There were some people I can talk to when I was single. But as soon as I came to the altar and I gave my vows and I committed myself to my wife, I can't say what I want to say. I can't go where I want to go. And God is saying, if you want to be married to me, if you want to be in a relationship with God, then you got to abide by the vows that we take. And the vows are that I'll let nothing separate me from the love of God. Keep on serving her. They talk about you. They're gonna scandalize your name. But it's alright. It's satisfying. It's satisfying. Yeah! Somebody here has been dealing with some stuff.
Yeah.
And God is saying, I'm going to handle it for you.
Yeah.
If you need my yeah.
Yeah.
God is saying, if you hunger yeah. after me, I'll fill the void. I'll make up the difference. I know you don't understand what's going on. But God is saying, hey, if you just hunger and thirst after me, I'll make everything all right.
Yeah.
Standing to your feet, standing to your feet, standing to your feet. If this word was for you, I want you to meet me at this altar. I want you to meet me at the altar because God is coming back for church without a spot or wrinkle. And now is the time where we as his children have to live a holy life.
Yeah.
It's quiet right here. I said, now is the time where God wants us to live a holy life. If you are not saved, if you are not saved, I want you to come to the altar. I want you to give your life to God because tomorrow is not promised. I said tomorrow is not promised. I was just told the other day that one of my managers had died. Just the other day, she got cancer. Tomorrow is not promised. Don't wait till next Sunday. Don't wait until next week. Don't wait until next month. Baby, get it together right now while you still got breath in your body. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. If you're not saved, if you're not saved, maybe you are saved, but someone will allow you back to
that
you want to get your hand right to God. Now it's your time to go. $138, amen. So if our bishop was here, he would make sure that budget is met, amen. So let's do our very best. Brother Josh, let's come for the basket and let's do what God has commissioned us to do, and that's to take care of his house, amen.
Amen.
Look at your name and say, ministry cost, ministry cost,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Ministry cost, let's do what we can to make sure that our budget is met, amen.
The world.
giving to meeting our budget. Amen. Now let's move into our pastor's appreciation. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
We do know that our bishop only lives on what we give him. Amen.
Amen.
He's not on salary at no church. Amen. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
He's not on salary at no church. And he only lives based on what we give him. So let's be fair to our bishop. Let's be a blessing to our man of God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's be a blessing to our man of God. Even right now, he's at the Calvary Church doing ministry work. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. He preached up a storm this morning at the Grace Temple Church.
Hallelujah.
The Lord, the hand of the Lord is on our mission. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And let's continue to lift him up in prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you for our bishop. We thank you for all that you're doing for him. God, continue to give him power and strength. And we pray, God, that whoever's going to sow into his life, that this offering be, that you will turn us off from recurring your spiritual use. And we give your name all the praise, glory, and honor. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God. Amen. Come on, let's give unto our bishop. Amen.
Things I'll never forget what you've done for me.
Church, and we want you to be completely satisfied. Amen. Our service starts promptly at 3 p.m. And our special guest will be Pastor Jeff Wilson of the Solid Rock Church. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's continue to pray for our bishop. He has a long week ahead of him with a revival at the Calvary Church. So let's pray his strength as he goes back and forth. Amen.
Amen.
With our minds on Christ, Lord, we thank you today for all that you have done. We thank you for your preached word. God, we pray, God, that you will change our lives. And as we leave this place, we never bring your presence. Give us traveling grace.
Amen.
So we can make it to and from home safely. We give your name all the praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and thank God. Hug your neighbor and tell them.
Hug me, baby.
Hug me, baby.